I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl?
It's a girl? A girl! We've got a daughter, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby girl.
Oh, James. We did it! Oh, a daughter. Oh. Our beautiful daughter.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, sweetie. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, sweetheart. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you?
Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly.
Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, beautiful. Just like her daddy.
It's a big world out there, honey, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
James.
Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
It's you and me. Okay?
Just remember one thing. We need a doctor, not a deadbeat.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations
now,
and there will be
no repercussions. James and his cheery charity.
Decorations, gifts, and the lights in this place will hurt your eyes. Just like home. It's just something you get used to down here.
Come on over here, sweetie. Come on. Walk to Daddy. Just a little further. Over here. Just a little further. You can do it.
Mama.
Come to Daddy. Over here. Come to Daddy. You can make it. Over here. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, honey. I'll be back in a bit. You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
These experiments
don't
are
damn it. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive.
Of course I miss her.
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! Can you believe it? She is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, honey. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young lady. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well... you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid. A liar. Okay, if you're so smart, what did I get you for your birthday? Okay. One last question. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. Yeah, I found this in a box of my father's old things. Can you believe it? Kind of weird to think about him reading comic books. I guess I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday!
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10. Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to you know.
What? Is she your best friend
Enjoying
now?
Yourself?
Hey, Wally, I think Paul's in love.
Attention, everyone.
Yeah,
it's
Paul.
Time to cut
Why don't you
the
introduce
cake?
Us to your new girlfriend? This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
What do you mean? Happy birthday, kid.
How's it going, sweetheart?
Oh, no.
Hello? I am mortified about the cake mishap. Simply mortified.
Hey, happy birthday, Nose. Nice party, but
Daddy,
didn't I tell you to stop bothering us?
All official. I know you were joking, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
Enjoying yourself? People always enjoy my little speeches. Besides, that friend of yours could use a reminder that life is not all fun and games. I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. That's not what I hear. But perhaps she'll set a good example for you. There's still plenty of time for you to make something of yourself.
Enjoying yourself? Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Such a nice, polite young lady you are. Don't ever lose your gift of speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday girl. No sharing required today.
Nice.
Do you think
boy.
We surprised
what
her?
Is that?
Hitler's butt. I'm one
sure
of 3,000 AMR.
Never suspected
what
a thing.
What piece of junk.
Now go on and enjoy yourself.
How do you like that there Pip-Boy, miss? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
Up every morning.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake! Give me that sweet roll you got from Old Lady Palmer. Talk about my mom, you little punk.
Thanks for coming, Stanley. I know you were busy with the water purifier.
Butch, what are you doing?
You, mistress?
Hitting a girl, and on her birthday, for heaven's sakes.
What are you looking at, dork face?
Did he hurt you, honey? I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about? Why, that little? I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
So, all right, what do you think
Butch.
We should call our
Hey, how about the
hey,
vote rolls? Get
how
it?
Are you enjoying
Cannon,
the party?
I've had
to
it with you, Butch.
All day
your mother
is
going to hear about this little incident.
Sometimes I think you... What did she tell you? Is it my fault? You didn't hear what she said to me.
You did such a splendid
job. I'm not going to tolerate any more of your bullying.
Fine, tell my mom. Big deal.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. Right, that's exactly what I was thinking.
How may I serve you, mistress?
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Oh dear,
Mr. Gomez. I'm glad you could make it.
Look good.
I'm glad to be here. I think it's important to get in touch with the young people.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem, just for you. I hope you like it. Don't be silly. One poem per birthday, that's my rule. If I gave you two, think how jealous Butch would be.
You know, as part of my job, plus, well, I like parties.
Sure thing, Officer Gomez.
Did you know the odds of a Vault-Tec shelter failing are?
What are you doing down here, young lady? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. Hey, relax. I was just teasing. Listen, now that you're 10, you don't have to take guff like that from grown-ups anymore. Got it? Hold on one more minute. I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me. Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old girl. So, yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either. That's what the overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here. Your mother, she was beautiful, but beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate about life, about love. But most of all, she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, honey, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner. Take care, sweetie. Now get out of here, and good luck.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old... Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us. It's the big goat day today, right?
Morning, Jonas.
You better stay away. I don't want you to catch what I've got.
I was just going over them. Something you're worried about?
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
I can show you a real tunnel snake. Tunnel snakes rule! That's us, and we rule! No one messes with the tunnel snakes, or they have to answer to Butch and Wally. You don't want to be on their bad sides. Trust me. None of your business, because Butch said so. And what Butch says goes. Tunnel snakes rule! You got that right. Better not forget it either. Can't think of anything. Butch says this little bitch is blabbing to her daddy about us tunnel snakes. We can't have that. Because we're the tunnel snakes, and we rule! Much later. Tunnel snakes rule! Amata.
God, Butch! Why don't you just leave me? Stupid tunnel snakes! Immature assholes, if you ask me! Why won't they leave me alone? It's not my fault my father's the overseer. I don't care about their stupid gang. Can you talk to them? Maybe Butch will listen to you. Please? Thanks. You've always been a good friend. Try talking to Butch. They'll all do whatever he says.
Show it to her, Butch.
Stay away from me.
Yeah? What do you want? Damn right. And you'll stay out of our way if you know what's good for you. No one messes with the tunnel snakes, especially not this stuck-up little daddy's girl. Maybe you're right. We can deal with her later. Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time. Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine. Let's go. What is it, Phoebe?
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
What seems to be the trouble?
I've got this headache that just won't go away. Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck.
You nervous? I'm not. Get out of my face.
Yes, I think I'd like that.
Leave me alone, you little spaz.
Come on, people, find your seats.
Oh, hi. Why are you talking to me? I hope you weren't just talking to me.
As soon as everyone takes their seats, we can get started. Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do?
Question 6. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question 7. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Thank God that's over. Come on, let's go get some lunch.
I've got other things. We'll talk to your little friend
What is
later.
It, Phoebe?
Oh, look, it's Doc's kid.
Here you are, Mr. Grunge.
Great.
I hope I did okay.
What do
okay.
you want, nerd girl?
Nothing for you to worry
Stop
about.
Stop bothering me. I've just got to figure out this last one.
Very well
We're not
done.
Friends.
Looks like
We're
it's
never going
Hi.
To
you.
Why are you talking to me?
Thanks. See you tomorrow.
I've got other things to do.
Well, well. Pip-Boy programmer, eh? Stanley will finally have someone to talk shop with. Yes, it's refreshing to see such, youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
Thank God that's over.
Yo, Teach.
Come
I'm
on,
done.
Let's go get some lunch.
Ah, Butch. Can I admit that I've been waiting for this day for a long, long time? Allow me to savor the moment.
I've Bye. Got other things to do.
Freddy. It's multiple choice. You can't really still be thinking about it.
Back off.
I can't figure out number 5. First, I think I should listen to my grandmother. But then, isn't killing someone wrong? I can't figure out number 5. First, I think I should listen to my grandmother. But then,
anything is possible,
someone,
even an A,
Daddy,
Mr. Brooks.
Dr. here to save you now.
Is he?
Back
so
to work.
Are you gonna
do now?
Selfish and insolent.
Look,
it's just like...
Wake
you
up!
You need to know
Come on,
things.
Wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up!
gross! Knock it off! This is serious!
My father's men are looking for you. They've already killed Jonas. You've got to get out of here. It's your dad. He's left the vault. My father thinks Jonas helped him escape. So he had his men. My God, they killed him. They just beat him and wouldn't stop. Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. Not this time. My father, he's not listening to anybody. If he even finds out that I've been helping you... But that doesn't matter. I can take care of myself. It's you he's looking for. And I have a plan. I know how to get you out of the vault. Well, I think it'll work. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
There she is. Hold it right there. Crime any more roaches. Holy smokes, that was close. Get it off me. I'm hit.
You gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches!
That is all.
No, I can't go back in there. It's dark, and there's rat roaches. You're the best!
Ow, that hurts! What's happening?
Okay, you're the best friend I've ever had, man. Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snakes jacket. Go ahead, take it.
This is the Overseer. All residents of Vault 101 are hereby confined to their quarters. The rat roach infestation is under control. Do not interfere with Vault security personnel. Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely. That is all.
Missy, I just... Oh, you're lucky it was me who found you. The others won't be so forgiving. I don't know what you're up to, and I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you. It's a real shame it's come to this. I can't believe what they did to Jonas. Officer Mack was just out of control. But you're a good kid. You didn't do anything to deserve this. Go find your dad if you can. Everybody's looking for, right? Me and Andy were in a tight spot there, ain't no mistake.
I believe.
Good thing he loves toasting roaches so much.
Could be back any moment.
Just hold still. Your left stabilizer's been knocked loose.
I am holding still. It's your old palsy hands that are shaking.
If you keep turning like that, I'm gonna crack your casing.
Don't blame me for your incompetence. Why, I remember George used to have the lightest touch. Those were the days.
I think I found the problem.
I don't believe you. I expect we'll be here for hours.
You were never here.
We should just go back to our quarters.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me!
Tom! Be careful!
There she is. There she is. What's the matter, huh? Can't stand the sight of...
Damn blood! No!
Ah!
think I found the problem.
Do not interfere with the security personnel.
Brooke, and submit to any further indignity.
Any resident found outside his
don't
or
be such an old woman. Just a few. Sir, it's the... I knew you'd turn up sooner or later. You're gonna be...
She's here! Don't let her get away!
I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young lady. You're all ready. I place the good of the vault above everything, even my own paternal feelings. We must not allow sentiment to cloud our judgment. But I admire your protective instincts. Very well. I give you my word that Amata will not suffer further because of your actions. Now then. If you really care about Amata, you will see how dangerous your father's actions were. Hand over your weapons, and put an end to this dangerous situation. There is no need to join your father as a traitor to the vault.
Thank you. That will make this easier.
Guards, help me! There she is!
You're no better than your father.
away from me! I can't talk to you right now. Get away from me! I can't talk to you right now.
Good, you're leaving. I guess you were trying to help me, but you... You didn't have to kill him!
Sam!
So you say. Maybe one day I'll be able to forgive you. But not now. I hope you never have to find out what it's like to see your father killed right in front of you. No! Don't listen to me. Just go! Find your father. I have to go bury mine. No, I can't. Not with you, not now. You'd better leave before I change my mind about letting you go.
Stop, gotcha, in the name of the Overseer.
Had enough!
Please, just go. I already said it.